funeral home. Please note that our washrooms are located to the north on your immediate left as you exit the building. Also, please take this opportunity to switch off or place your cell phones on silent. In the event of an emergency, an alarm will sound and an official of Belgrove's funeral home will direct you to the nearest exit towards the muster point. The exits are clearly marked, one through the back, you turn right leading through the main entrance, and one to the south immediately outside the chapel and to the left. Our muster point is located to the northwest end of the car park near the Hindu Gardens. No emergency drills are planned for today. In the unlikely event of an emergency, please remain calm. Exit the building using the nearest exit doors and head towards the muster point. At the muster point, please check to see that everyone in your party is present and immediately inform a Belgrove's official if anyone is missing. Please note that all Belgrove's officials are easily identified by the company's ID badge. If for any reason you find yourself in need of any assistance, please do not hesitate to call on us. Thank you for your attention.
Good afternoon, sisters and brothers. Can we please stand? We begin our service in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the waters of baptism, Cynthia died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Please join in singing the entrance hymn, Blessed Assurance.
Jesus is mine, oh what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture burst on my sight. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Can you take your seats, please? So good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the funeral liturgy for Cynthia Howard. My name is Neil Parsonlal. I'm one of the lay ministers attached to the Catholic Church in Arouca. For circumstances beyond our control, we're having the service here today, and we welcome all of you to the service. How the service proceeds, we have the eulogy, and then we'll have an invitation to prayer. After the eulogy, we have a tribute song, which will be done by Marvin, and then we'll have the opening prayer, and the liturgy will follow thereafter. So I ask you to sit back, and as we listen to the eulogy done by Charmaine. Charmaine?
Good afternoon, I'm Charmaine Lewis, and Cynthia Howard is my aunt.
Good afternoon.
I'm Renan Howard, and Cynthia is my grandmother.
Cynthia wasn't born a Howard. She was born Cynthia Doldron on the 27th of June, 1945, to Edward and Mildred Doldron. Actually, she recently celebrated her 75th birthday. She was 75 years young. And if you look at the program, just under the hymn, Into Your Hands, you will see some of the pictures that were taken on her 75th birthday, just June gone. Cynthia grew up in Point Fortin, but the family moved to Gonzales, Port of Spain, when she was 17. In 1965, she became employed as an accountant at Standard Motors Limited. Her brother Andy, there in the corner, remembers that she used part of her first pay, as we called it then, to buy him a pair of short pants. It was at Standard that she met the love of her life, Lloyd Howard. Cynthia Doldron and Lloyd Howard were married on the 26th of December, 1968. It was a Boxing Day. Their anniversary was celebrated every year with a large family gathering. It was the ultimate Christmas lime, which family and friends look forward to. There was plenty of good food, which she prepared, drinks, good music, and a great lime. Auntie Cynthia welcomed everyone with a hug and a full plate of food. Some were even lucky to leave with a whole black cake and a bottle of Punch a Creme. The fondest and most cherished Christmas memories for the family was that anniversary Christmas line. It was a lot of work preparing for this event, but Lloyd and Cynthia looked forward to it regardless, simply because it meant they would be surrounded by family and friends. Sadly, Lloyd passed just 23 days before he and Cynthia will have celebrated 49 years of marriage, 49 years of partnership, 49 years of friendship and love. To her siblings, she was always Cynthia and very rarely Cynthia. As a big sister, Cynthia believed that anything was possible if you worked hard for it, which she always did by setting the example for others to follow. She was always a strong-willed woman. Even when she was young, Cynthia had an amazing strength and force about her. No one could distract her from her goals. After the passing of her parents, Cynthia became the matriarch of the family. As the big sister, matriarch Cynthia was a serious, headstrong, no-nonsense lady. However, she was always there for her siblings when they needed her help, just to give support, care, concern, and love. Though three of her siblings have lived abroad for several years, She always maintained a close relationship with them because for Auntie Cynthia, family was everything. Family was life. To her sister Yolan, she was her best friend. They were almost like twins. Yolan and Cynthia would talk to each other on the phone practically every day about anything and everything. Long ago, their talks were about what was the latest on The Bold and Beautiful. More recently, it was what was good to watch on Netflix. We thank her brothers, Barbara and Lester, for sending some of the foregoing sentiments. Her youngest sister, Lisa, also sent a special note, which reads as follows. Cynthia was the perfect example of a wife, mother, sister, and friend. Her greatest accomplishment was her children, and from that, we can all see she have raised them to be honorable, kind, and exceptional men and women. In them, her legacy continues. When our mother died, I recall we were standing at her bedside crying. I was 12 years old, and I felt insecure and afraid of what the future would mean for me without my mother. Cynthia, in the midst of her grief, reached out and took my hand and told me, "Don't worry, I will take care of you," and that she did. Believe me, I did not make it easy for her to keep that promise. Remember, she was going to be raising a teenager. But she did it because she loved her family. She was strong, loyal, and faithful woman to the end. She was not only my sister, she became my mother and my role model. So my sisters and nephews don't call me auntie because I was raised right alongside them. I am their big sister. I will miss my chats with her when she would say, "Don't worry about that, it will be okay. You can do whatever you set your mind to do, no matter what the issue may be." She was always very optimistic and that if you put forth the effort, you would reap good rewards. Now I look forward to the day when we would all be reunited as promised by God in John chapter 5, verses 28 to 29, which reads, "For the hour is coming in which all of those in the memorial tombs will hear his voice and come out," end of quote. That would be a glorious day for us all. So I don't say goodbye to her. I say, "See you soon, Lisa." To my mother, Gloria in the wheelchair there, who was the eldest of four sisters, Auntie Cynthia displayed only kindness, respect, and appreciation, calling her ever so often simply to check up on her. But the most significant part of her life, besides Lloyd, was her children. To her children, Jillian, Giselle, Sean, and Renee, Cynthia was a dedicated mother, loving and caring. She never let them, even as adults, forget who was the boss. And she would say her favorite quote was, "I brought you here, and I can send you back." So you knew not to give any back chat, but simply to engage in meaningful conversation. Auntie Cynthia was straightforward, subtle, but brutally honest. Traits seem to be in her children. If you were wrong about something, she would let you know. And that was for everybody, not just her children. She was her children's confidant, their fierce protector, and even my medical consultant. She would always be recommending some vitamin or telling them, "You better go to the doctor and get that checked out." Cynthia was successful in giving each of her children a good and happy life. But everything revolved around her children. However, that did not mean she didn't work hard to make herself happy. She loved reading, cooking, and satisfying her sweet tooth. There was a time for a long while that she actually only had ice cream for dinner. Cynthia took pride in her home and was happy decorating it, especially around Christmas time, which she absolutely loved. She worked hard to make every Christmas and the best Christmas for her family. And this year, my Uncle Gussie, there, her brother, will sadly miss coming up to Bonnie to administer the final touches at Christmas time. But whether it was Christmas time or other times,
It was at this home that her brother Ken found a relaxing, comfortable environment to spend time with his sister. When Cynthia became a grandmother, she insisted that when Renan learned to speak, he would call her Granny. Renan brought her great pride and joy. She was a dedicated and devoted grandmother and surrounded Renan with love and attention.
My granny was a fighter. She has had a few medical challenges over the years and has always come back stronger than ever. Some may even say brand new. This time around, she vowed to fight again despite the odds, and she had every confidence that with God by her side, she would beat this new challenge. She felt it, and we believed her. And we believed it. God, however, had other plans. She leaves to mourn her four children, her one and only grandson, her loving siblings, and many loving nieces and nephews. She now joins her husband, Lloyd Howard, her parents, and two of her brothers, James and Hammond. Granny will always be remembered for her strength and perseverance, her brilliance and optimism. Cynthia's love for her family will not only remain in our memories, but in our hearts. We love you, Cynthia. We love you, Cynthia. We love you, Mommy. I love you, Granny.
Thank you.
I glimpse eternity. stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up. You raise me up. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Sisters and brothers, can we stand, please? Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Granted through this mystery, your servant Cynthia, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. So we have the first reading.
The reading from Daniel 12, verse 1 to 3. At that time shall arise Michael, the great prince, who has charge of your people, and there shall be a time of trouble such as never has been since there was a nation till that time. But at that time your people shall be delivered. Everyone whose name shall be found written in the book. Just give me a minute. And many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. And those who are wise shall shine like the brightness of the sky above, and those who turn many to righteousness like the stars forever and ever. This is the word of the Lord.
Second reading, sorry. There's a second reading.
First letter of Paul to the Romans, chapter 6, verse 3 to 4 and 8 to 9. So by our baptism into his death, we were buried with him, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the Father's glorious power, we too should begin living a new life. If we have been joined to that our former self was crucified with him, so that the self which belonged to sin should be destroyed, and we should be freed from the slavery of sin.
Would we believe that if we died?
But if we believe that if we died with Christ, then we shall live with him too. We know that Christ has been raised from the dead, and will never die again. Death has no power over him anymore. For by dying, he is dead to sin once and for all. And now the life that he lives is life with God. In the same way, you must see yourselves as being dead to sin, but alive for God in Christ Jesus.
Stand for the gospel affirmation.
Alleluia, alle, alle, alle. Alleluia, alle, alle, alle. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Your words are spirit, Lord, and they are life. You have the message of eternal life.
Alle, 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 alleluia. Alle, 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 alleluia. Alle, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory.
Then Jesus said to his disciples, "If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. Anyone who wants to save his life will lose it, but anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. What then will anyone gain by winning the whole world and forfeiting his life? Or what can anyone offer in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man is going to come in the glory of his Father with the angels, and then he will reward each one according to his behavior. In truth, I tell you, there are some standing here who will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming with his kingdom." Sisters and brothers, the gospel, the good news of the Lord. Please be seated. So pleasant afternoon again to everyone. The gospel passage you just heard is the passage that Catholics throughout the world will hear today. Wherever you are in the world as a Catholic, if you go to Mass, if you attend any of the rituals of the Catholic liturgy today, this is the gospel passage that you will hear. Whether you're in France, whether you're in Timbuktu, whether you're in Africa, wherever you find yourself, this is the reading that you would have heard. And as I reflected on the readings for today, we have the option in funeral liturgies to change the readings if we want to something that is perhaps a little more death-oriented. But I felt it was important for us to stay with today, the readings for us today, because it asks the question really about discipleship, about how is it do we become disciples and how do we exercise our discipleship? And in the context of a funeral, in the context of someone who has died and has lived as full a life as Cynthia has, then how do we celebrate that discipleship? Amen? How do we celebrate that discipleship? Because, you know, Jesus says to the disciples, if anyone wants to be a follower of mine, you have to renounce yourself and take up your cross and follow me. And sisters and brothers, you and I know, you see this taking up cross thing? It's not easy. This thing about taking up your cross and follow, because there are plenty crosses out there. It have plenty crosses for you to take up there, out there. From the time you get up in the morning till you go to bed at night, you will bounce up plenty, plenty cross. I have some of them, you don't want to take them up, you know. You want to pelt them as far as you could pelt them. So you see this taking up cross thing? Is not easy at all. Is not easy. Following or taking the decision, making a decision to be a disciple of Jesus, requires a level of self-denial and a level of self-sacrifice that many of us have difficulty with. And sometimes we start, you know, we say, well, yes, you know, we're hot and sweaty. We're following Jesus. And then something happens, you're driving down the road and somebody gave you a bad drive. And you take out Jesus, put him in your pocket, cuss with everybody, and then start back again. That's the life. That's the life. Taking up your cross every day. Every day. Not today, and then the following day, and then you skip a day and come back. But it's about taking up your cross every day and following Jesus. And when we listened to the eulogy, and we listened to the kind of life that Cynthia lived, we listen to the kind of person that she was, her struggles and her love for her children, her love for her one and only grandchild, the love that she, you know, she celebrated with, you know, 49 years of marriage with her husband. And, you know, it's rare that as a lay minister, you get to do both funerals, because I was the presider at the husband's funeral, and here I am today presiding over the funeral for, you know, for Cynthia. But we come to the experience of Christ wanting to do well, wanting to take up the cross and follow Jesus. And there are so many things that cause us, brothers and sisters, to fall by the wayside. There are so many things that cause us to or attract our attention that we go off in different directions. And Jesus says to the disciples, you know, what then will it gain anyone to win the whole world and forfeit his soul? We know it in a different way. What should it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Yeah? There are so many things. There are so many distractions. There are so many choices. And particularly in today's context, when you have red, blue, yellow, green, all kind of thing to choose from. There are many of us who are selling our souls for different colors. Are we following Christ? Are we picking up our cross and following Jesus? Because that's the cost of discipleship. As parents, you would know the difficulty you have in raising your children. You know, the old people tell us, you make your children, but you don't make the mind. So you could do what you want, preach Paul and argue salt, and say that you want the best for your child. And you do everything that you can. And you try to grow up your child in the right way. And somebody comes along, and lead your one piece of child astray. Are we prepared as parents to take up that cross? To take up that cross? In my professional life, in my work, you know, I have had to go and take, you know, rescue children, you know, from their homes. In the middle of the night, a child will call me and say, you know, Uncle Neil, come and get me. My mother put me out. And I've had to go and pick them up at the side of the road with a bag of clothes. Because as parents, we're not prepared to take up that cross every day and follow Jesus. As husbands and wives, as partners, as spouses, are we prepared to take up that cross every day and follow Jesus? Because some of us ain't easy to live with, you know. Some of us as husbands, we ain't easy to live with, you know. And all your wives are backward. So don't feel it's only men. We're not easy to live with. I tell people all the time, my wife will get me into heaven. Because from her I learned how to be patient. It's from my wife I learned how to be patient. And I'm sure she's saying the same thing. I will be the one to get into the heaven. But thank God both of us going to reach up there. Both of us going to reach. Because we have taken a decision to take up that cross every day and follow Jesus. And there are many of us as spouses, as husbands and wives, who decide and not in this taking up cross thing. So at the slightest hint of, you know, of trouble, I going back by my mother. I going back by my father. Are we prepared to take up our cross every day and follow Jesus? And that's what Jesus invites us to do as disciples, sisters and brothers. That's what Jesus invites us to do if we want to have the resurrection glory at the end. Because there is no crown without the cross. There is no crown without the cross. You have to take up that cross every day. And I'm sure Cynthia's life, 49 years of marriage, that ain't easy, you know. That ain't easy. Having to raise, you know, our friend who did the eulogy and, you know, talked about Lisa, the sister. Having as a young person to raise your 12-year-old sister, you know, and the rest of your siblings can't be easy. And sometimes you say, I ain't sign up for this. I ain't sign up for this. But that is part of taking up the cross. And that is what Cynthia did. Take up a cross and follow Jesus. I was having a conversation with my staff before I came up about 2 hours for, you know, you have to give your staff 2 hours to go and vote on election day. And all kind of drama because they want to know if the office closing early, if they get in the hour for lunch plus your 2 hours to go. And I have to say, but what all if you be running here? Is that parlor? But you have to take up your cross every day and follow Jesus. Cynthia's life, if we want to honor that life, it means following in Cynthia's footsteps by taking up that cross every day. Renan said, you know, that when she fell ill on this last occasion, she said she was going to beat it. But this is one time she didn't come back. This is one time when God had more in store for her. And if we want to be there with her on that last day, then we have a choice to make. Because if when we come to funerals, the funerals are not just for the dead, you know. Funerals are not just for the deceased. The funerals are for each and every one of us who gather at the funeral. And if you leave here this afternoon without one pull on your conscience in terms of, am I living my life so that when if I walk out the road or if I drive out the road and I'm dead right there, that are ready for God, then you waste your time coming here today. You waste your time. Funerals must allow us to see and come to grips with our own mortality, that we will die too. That this is, in fact, a dress rehearsal for our own funeral. It's just that we are going to be lying down in the box and someone else will be eulogizing us. Amen? As we celebrate Cynthia's life today, let us ask ourselves that question. Are we taking up our cross? Are we ready? Are we prepared? Are we being patient with ourselves? Because sometimes we're not patient with ourselves, you know. We want it to happen and we want it to happen fast. But God ain't finished with us yet. God ain't finished with you yet. And God ain't finished with me yet. We have plenty work to do. I know certainly for me, he have plenty work to do on me. He ain't finished with me yet. Yeah? But every day, every morning I get up, I'm going to ask him, please, Papa God, give me the strength to take up that cross and follow him. And that's all we could ask. So that when our name is called up yonder, I'm not going to say when we sign our name with any color pen, but when our name is called up yonder, we will be sure that we are ready to confront our Jesus. Amen? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'll ask you to remain seating. What we have now is a number of intercessions. So we pray your response is, Lord, graciously hear us. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. And so we pray for Cynthia, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of saints. Lord, hear us. We pray for our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, hear us. We pray for our deceased relatives and friends and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us. And we pray for those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, hear us. We pray for the family and friends of our sister Cynthia, that they may be consoled in their grief by Jesus, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us. And we pray for all of us who assembled here together to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Let us join our hearts together, sisters and brothers, and pray as Jesus himself taught us to pray, as we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We do not have an offertory in the normal sense, but there's a song that we supposed to sing during the offertory, How Great Thou Art. I invite you to join the choir in singing How Great Thou Art.
When I know some wonder, consider all the works thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burdens gladly bearing. He bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Cynthia, and now we come to the last farewell. There is always sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship. And although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Into your hands
we commend our spirit, O Lord, into your hands. We commend our hearts, for we must die to ourselves in loving you. Into your hands
we commend our hearts.
Father of mercies, we commend our sister in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Cynthia, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Sisters and brothers, we gather today to commend our sister Cynthia to God our Father and to commit her body to the elements. In the spirit of faith in the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, let us raise our voices in prayer and offer our prayers for Cynthia. And because God has chosen to call our sister from this life to himself, we commit her body to the elements, for we are dust. And unto dust we shall return.
I will proclaim your name to all the world, God of our fathers and our God too. Your name shall sound from every voice, O Lord.
Soon every heart will worship you.
But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise up her body on the last day. Sisters and brothers, I invite you to stand. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You're attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen our hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May the love of God and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ bless and console us, and gently wipe every tear from our eyes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Cynthia Howard, may the angels lead you today into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you, Cynthia, find eternal rest. Sisters and brothers, our service is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Please join our final hymn.
On my way to the Lord, to my Lord, 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 to my Lord's house, I'm walking on my way to the Lord, to my Lord who's waiting there for me. So let's all join hands and praise the Lord. Yes, love, O Lord, 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 go to our Lord's house. So let's all join hands and praise the Lord. Go to our Lord who's waiting patiently. I'm singing on my way to the Lord.
To my Lord, Lord, Lord,
to my Lord's house. I'm singing on my way to the Lord. To my Lord who's waiting there for me. So let's all join hands and praise the Lord. Yes, love, O Lord, 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 go to our Lord's house. So let's all join hands and praise the Lord. Go to our Lord who's waiting patiently. I'm clapping on my way to the Lord. To my Lord, 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 to my Lord's house, I'm clapping on my way to the Lord. To my Lord who's waiting there for me, so let
let's all join hands and praise the Lord.
Yes,
go
love
our Lord, 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 go to our Lord's house. So let's all join hands and praise the Lord. Go to our Lord who's waiting patiently.
Sisters and brothers, I think there'll be another opportunity to view her body. So I invite you to do so and have a good evening.
thankful.